this NBA presentation. With
turn it out to one, out to one, out to one.
Anthony and Clark Kellogg. This is Kevin Harlan. Doris Burks on the sideline as well. Last game for the Nets, a loss to the Pistons.
And if there's one aspect of the game that really stood out for me, it was the rebounding. Basketball is about possessions, and you saw a noticeable difference in terms of the effort both teams were putting forth.
Simply got outworked under the boards, guys. I mean, that's the no-brainer of the deal. I mean, they got pushed around all game long.
Good start reading, okay? Love you. I love your outfit, man.
And so off the two, it's Brooklyn. So the Nets starting five. We've got Jackson Lee out there with Jarrett Jack, and it's Brooke Lopez. And it's Young in at the four-man position. No one covering. Lopez has got his team on the board to start the game for Brooklyn.
Good make to get things underway.
Yeah, and always a relief, I think, to get those first points.
Brooklyn leading by four, and Doris Burke caught up with Coach Greg Popovich. Doris?
I asked him about the matchup problems created by a player like Andrea Bargnani, a 7-foot sharpshooter. He said he can give us problems, no doubt. It's tough to really bother that shot, and he can also put it on the deck and drive. We've got to just get into his body, try to make him a facilitator rather than a scorer. Kevin, we'll see if they're successful.
And thanks for that story, Doris. Screen by Young. Here's Lopez. Goes back up. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up, and two shots coming up.
All right, a chance to check out stats for Leonard. Good season for him last year. Last season, put up about 14 points a game, 8 rebounds, and 3 assists. Just solid all-around performances we've been seeing from him, delivering night in and night out.
And you know, that's what stars do. It isn't always about scoring 50 points. It's about making plays consistent.
Y'all reading?
And he knocks down the first one. A different look now for San Antonio. West comes in for LaMarcus Aldridge. And it's Mills in for Parker. Robinson's checked in for Brooklyn. He's off on the second. Well, it was the San Antonio Spurs in their last game, a loss to Denver.
That final score really caught a lot of people off guard. I think we would have to quantify that one as an upset.
Yeah, I thought they really tightened up at the end, guys. I mean, I think they were playing not to lose instead of playing to win. You got to go after wins. You can't try to hold on to them. You got to go get them.
Right.
Spurs trail by three. And here's Mills. Outside, Green. From 12 feet out. His first shot is a miss. 0 for 1 to start the contest. Now here's Freak. Covered by Mills. So he earns a trip to the line. Officials on the contact, and he'll shoot two. For Brooklyn, they have shot a good percentage from the free throw line so far. They've made 5 out of 6.
And their numbers from the line last season, they're good, just not great. About 77% as a team.
You know, Kevin, they would love to post a similar percentage again this season. I mean, I think that's safe to say they'd love to shoot free throws as well as they did a year ago.
And the Nets making a change here. Hollis Jefferson's checked in. And now running it up the court. Green pushing it all the way. West outside. He dishes it to Leonard. Here's Duncan. That's good, and it's Leonard with the assist. Duncan's got his first 2 points. The Nets with the lead. Jack dishes to Freak. They get it back. Robinson, and the layup's good off the glass.
And the rebound and the follow show you what he is all about. Gritty and determined with a soft touch to match.
To the middle, stolen by Bargnani. Campbell with it, 9 points last game. and he buries that one, drilling the rim on the way down.
How about that move? Is this guy special or what? Just love watching him operate inside.
Mills passes to Duncan. Leonard on the wing. And a miss there on the triple. Nets leading by six. 6 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Picked by Bargnani. Inside. Here's Robinson. And a beautiful feed leads to a monster jam.
Boy, I love the great assist that time by Jack.
And San Antonio has possession. Now Mills. 9 points last game out. And there's the feed to Leonard. Corner shot. No good.
Very dangerous to leave a guy like that open. Lucky break there for the D.
A free-flowing first quarter. Great scoring through one. Nets lead by eight. And Spurs head coach Greg Popovich, very demanding. Throughout the years, he was hardest on his point guard, Tony Parker. And here's what Parker had to say about that.
My first 3-4 years, it was tough sometimes. Sometimes, like, eyes watered. I was, like, really angry, and it was tough at times. Definitely very hard on me early in my career.
Even though it seems like that was a very long time ago now, to hear Tony Parker talk about
it. Did he acknowledge, Kevin, that he cried?
It sounds like, yeah.
The game made him cry. That's one of the things fans forget about with professional athletes. No matter how successful they get, players never forget that pain and frustration or those other emotions they've gone through to help get them to where they are.
Now the second quarter getting ready to start up. And from Brooklyn, guys, what jumps out to you stat-wise?
They've won the effort battle, and that's allowed them to control the backcourt.
And it's been gang rebounds. I mean, everybody has done a great job boxing out for them, and it's showing up on the stat sheet.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, as the second quarter gets going. On the court for San Antonio. The timeless Parker and Manu are the one and the two. Aldridge out there with Maurice Spates, and it's Green in at the small forward position. Spurs trail by 10. Parker kicks to Aldridge. Spates sets a screen. Johnson against Green. 5 to shoot. No good from Ginobili.
With the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be, firmly in control of this game.
And no doubt about it, rebounding is an effort stat, folks. They've been more determined than their opponent thus far.
Here's Parker. And so he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot two.
And really the defense fouling there to prevent the layup, but that's exactly what you need to do.
It is. I mean, no reason to back off and give him the layup. Much better off making him go to the line.
And a chance for just a second now to check out the scoring.
It don't have a lot of words.
They made an effort to get to the line here in the first half, guys. And it's starting to pay off.
You got 30 minutes.
The other thing that's helped them early tonight are the points they've been able to convert off turnover.
Morris Diaz checked in for Daniel Green.
That should be a piece of cake. Out of all day, you didn't go to school.
Off on that one, so he goes 1 for 2 at the line. Nets leading by 9. And we're a little over a minute and a half into the second quarter of action.
Move the ball. Stick it too much.
Here's Campbell. And that one comes up a bit short. San Antonio's gone 0-2 from deep here in the second. Ginobili kicks to Spates. That falls. Nice feed that time from Manu Ginobili. Spates has got his first points in this one.
Here we go, San Antonio. Please give it up for the Spurs dance team.
A moment here to see some stats for Parker. How he performed last season. 15th in field goal percentage, and he was also among the top 20 in steals. That ability is more unique than folks realize. Very valuable defensively.
And as you said, one of the more efficient scorers in the league last year. He showed great shot selection, more often than not, sent it home.
Nets have gone 1 of 3 to start out the second quarter. Johnson gets to Lee. Back to Johnson. Lopez sets a screen for Johnson. Tipped away. Feeds to Freak. Front past the arc. That's good. Freak's got the lead up to 10 now for the Nets. The Spurs shooting at 44%. Pretty reasonable. Parker drives in. Spates dishes to Parker. Tries it from 19. Rebound, Brooklyn.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
And what I like about it, Greg, it's been a physical brand of basketball. It's had a little sandpaper element to it. Gritty and rough, but that's how you win games.
And Diaw kicks to Aldridge. Goes up on the high post, connects, the jumper drops. Aldridge has got his second bucket.
You know, as soon as he recognized the height mismatch, he immediately pulled up for the jumper.
And, Greg, that's just good basketball. Come on, good basketball there. Clean look from that range. He's got to take it.
Boy, Lopez hunkered down and anchored in on that pick.
Parker passes to Ginobili. Spates gets to Diaw.
What we doing?
Nice ball movement by San Antonio.
Tom.
Spates with a screen on Lee. Ginobili dishes to Spates. 5 to shoot. Rebound, Brooklyn. Lopez has got his third rebound on the night. Here's Johnson. Offensive rebound. That's good. And the Nets lead by 12.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
And on the flip side, Greg, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior. They've got to offer more resistance here.
And now, your Spurs 15.
I feel it. Lily, you should be in the other room. So, Kayla, what you got running in there? Are you reading? Okay. Let's make sure. Okay. Tell me all about when you're done when reading time is over. I know what you're reading, Lily. You're reading Dragon Ball Z. You're reading Dragon Ball Z.
With this break, let's show you the teams that led the league in assists last year. Number 5, the Spurs.
Just a gifted passing team. They play the kind of basketball that fans.
Shit, I will bust you, Redula. Bullet hole that start to. Red light start to rumors. I stay on.
So San Antonio going with an almost entirely new group here. Duncan, he's checked in for Spates. West comes in for LaMarcus Aldridge. Kawhi Leonard's checked in for Boris Diaw. And it's Mills in for Manu Ginobili. And a new group in for the Nets. Bargnani has checked in for Lopez. Thomas Robinson comes in for Samuel Dalembert. Hollis Jefferson's checked in for Johnson. And Jared Jack is subbed in for Courtney Lee. And it's out of bounds. The Nets will take it the other way.
And that's just carelessness there. I mean, you have got to have your head in the game.
Closing in on 4 minutes played here in the second quarter. Jack passes to Campbell. Passes it to Hollis Jefferson. Dishes it to Freak. Shot clock at 6. And again, Brooklyn with the triple.
And when he's got that much of a height advantage on the perimeter, it's really tough on the defender. Easy three-pointer.
Outside Leonard looking to end the run. And it's good. And the assist by Parker. That's 10 points for Kawhi Leonard.
Okay.
Sometimes trailing in a game, players get sucked into trying to make that home run play.
Yeah, trying to get it all back in a hurry. And you're right on that. But these threes they're taking have not helped. They're trying to catch fire. They've yet to find the match.
San Antonio making a switch here. Green's checked in.
Double team.
There's a minute 34 left in the second quarter. It'll go, and the next lead is kept down now.
Come on now. That's 9 points. They
don't came up. Outstanding patience and decision making for them offensively.
Absolutely. Their ball movement has been outstanding, and they're piling up the assists.
And there's the pass to Campbell. Just five on the clock. Pass to Bargnani. And misses it off the right side of the rim.
They really depend on him to convert those chances. A lot of times, even with solid D draped on him, they expect him to make it.
Shots good by Mills.
All these open threes they're giving up have really been the driving force of this run.
And the points are starting to add up in a hurry, especially when you're giving up those looks from deep.
Here's Campbell. No good. They had a chance to end the run there. Spurs trail by six.
Clearly a two-for-one situation here, guys.
Oh, without question, Greg. I mean, the wise move would be to get themselves a quick shot so they have an opportunity to get that two.
A nice run they put together here to bring it a little closer.
Yeah, they got hot. I didn't think I'd be saying this a little while ago, but now this game's up for grabs.
1 second separate in the shot clock and game. Leonard kicks to Mills. The three. And again, it's the Spurs from deep.
Out of their last 5 makes. How about all five from long range?
Well, the defense just hasn't pressed up to deny any of those looks, guys. I mean, they're hanging back and getting picked apart.
No good from Jack. And so it's tied as we head to halftime. We'll see you back here after the break for third quarter basketball.
All y'all did is tie it up. I'm gonna let them niggas get back in the game. By me doing that last little bit in the last 2 minutes. I wish I could start seeing me. Well, I don't never see them with, like, the whole team. They always, like, duck, dog.
All right, listen up, everybody. The second half doesn't have to be as close as the first if we pay attention to a couple of things. Firstly, our offensive output in the paint was really encouraging. But that being said, let's make sure we don't get too one-dimensional in the second half. I want us getting points from the inside and out. I do like that we limited our turnovers. We weren't careless with the ball or making unforced errors. So kudos for that. And in terms of pace, I'd like to see us calm it down once the third gets started. We shouldn't be in any kind of rush.
Yes, sir.
We have a close ball game on our hands as we get set for the second half of basketball.
Leonard playing extremely well. 16 points, and the three-pointers have been dropping for him. He's got three of them.
And you know what, Clark? If you continue to shoot the way he is, he may have to become more of an integral part of their offensive scheme.
Tony Duncan, he's checked in for Spates. DL comes in for LaMarcus Aldridge. And it's Green in for Mono Ginobili. And then for Brooklyn, Samuel Dalembert is checked in for Lopez. Bargnani comes in for Joe Johnson. And it's Campbell in for Jarrett Jack. So for Brooklyn now, Campbell in at point guard. Young out there with Bargnani. Then it's Lee, and it's Dalembert in at the five, roaming the paint. Screen by Duncan. Parker. And he gets the shot to fall after coming off the pick. Parker's got his third bucket of the night.
A lot of space right there to get that shot off.
Not a very good job of the defender getting over the top of that screen in that particular play.
And that one's good.
I love the advantage he has from a speed standpoint. Does a great job of creating separation for that shot.
Clark, they've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a little bit of cotton mouth here. Dry spell for sure.
Great D that time from Campbell. Nets leading by five. Lee gets to D'Alembert. Bargnani against Diaw. No good from Bargnani.
Excellent. Really solid job, actually, by the defense to get in his way as he was going up for that one.
Pass to Diaw. A three from Leonard. And it's Leonard again missing.
And still looking for his first triple of the second half. He had three at halftime.
Young in the corner. D'Alembert dishes to Freak. The Nets working the ball around now. Young passes to Bargnani. Just four to shoot. Goes to the fadeaway and hands it.
I love the ball movement there. He put that on a silver platter. Just served him up.
Now the dish to Diaw. Wide open one. That drops. And it comes off an assist from Parker. Parker's got three assists now in this one. Brooklyn's gone 0-2 from deep to start things here in the second half. Campbell against Parker. Now here's Freak. Guarded close. Pulls up. Green with the rebound. Spurs trail by five. Parker with a clean look. No good on the triple.
No doubt it's been a bit of a struggle for him here in this quarter in terms of scoring.
Here's Campbell. Shot is up. And San Antonio will go the other way with it. And this is their first time matched up with Brooklyn this year.
And it was a matchup you thought they would have.
When that phone goes off, that's when you got an RV.
In this series last year.
When that phone goes off.
One split from two teams on the opposite side of the standings. You know, as we've said many times.
Once that phone go off, that's when you got an RV.
Two free throws in the game, made one and missed one. No good on the free throw.
What?
And the Nets are going to change here. He hits the second from the line. Here's Leonard. He's got 21. Screened by Duncan. Leonard kicks to Mills. Three-pointer. The shot is off.
And no excuse there for missing that one after being freed up by a great pick.
Yeah, I agree with you. I mean, they came away empty, but they got the look they wanted, and really, I like the movement and communication there.
All right, the fourth quarter of action getting underway. We've had a great one so far with both sides coming to play. Here's Hollis Jefferson. Manu and Kawhi filling out the perimeter. Aldridge out there with West, and it's Mills in at the point. That's the San Antonio five. And so it's Brooklyn with the win. This was a hard-fought, well-earned victory for him, Greg. They really had to work for this win.
Yeah, that's a good point. I mean, weaker teams might have buckled at the end with the crowd amped up, everyone in the building kind of rooting against you. But they stood tall and pulled it out.
Well said. And that about wraps it up. This is Kevin Harlan thanking you for watching. And now...
The 2K Sports Postgame Show.
Thank you, Kevin. And now we get a chance to present our Jordan player of the game, Brooke Lopez. The fourth quarter was all him. It was like he couldn't miss, and it was just one basket after another.
Well, he showed us just how good he can be when he's at the top of his game. and the building was stunned. You saw people leaving early, throwing popcorn, throwing hot dogs, spilling soda. You put on a CSDP, a crowd shutdown performance. Man, that's what I'm talking about, Ernie.
Just a dominant display by Brook Lopez in the post tonight. Lopez is a threat on multiple levels. His offense is always going to be there, but his defense isn't far behind. And I don't think he gets enough credit for his rebounding either. He's solid all around.
And folks, that's it for us. Thank you for tuning in. Always a pleasure. For Kenny the Jet Smith, for Shaquille O'Neal, this is Ernie Johnson. Have a great night.
Associated with Cloudy Bad 32, you heard me? Are y'all reading? Alright. I say alright.
the 2K Sports pregame show.
Hey, everybody, I'm Ernie Johnson, and trick-or-treating door-to-door with me tonight are Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. Happy Halloween, everybody.
Trick-or-treat, give me something good to eat.
In this game, we'll see the Chicago Bulls against the Brooklyn Nets at Barclays Center. And for Brooklyn, they struggled in this matchup last season. Only one win for them through four games. They'd like to make a statement tonight. And guys, we'll get to see Freak play in this one. He was one of the bigger names in college. Jumped to the NBA after 1 year. Shaq, you left early as well. How hard of a decision was it to leave school?
Well, it's never an easy decision. Each person has different reasons why they want to leave. Financial responsibility, just getting tired. In my case, the Hack of Shaq was created. I was getting beat up too much. And I heard my main man, Dick Vitale, say if Shaq leaves, he'll be the number one pick. So I didn't want to go back, get hurt, and possibly drop.
Yeah, because you could have been number two if you stayed a year, I tell you. But, you know, this guy, Freak. Because if you would have played in that era with Freak, I don't know Shaq. This guy, you know, he left school early, but he is something unique, different. But I thought bringing his skills to the NBA was big because that helps refine your game a little bit. He's ready. This guy was ready, Shaq.
I have an announcement. You know why he plays so well?
Why?
I'm his father.
Dun, 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 dun.
Love you, son. Congratulations.
Yeah, I feel like you got like a forever booger life. But
warmest
it ain't
and fuzziest
like
stories I've heard all season.
Way to keep
long.
Up with him his whole life.
I've been working.
Let's go to Kevin Harlan. They're ready for the tip.
College.
I've been working.
These niggas literally were just sitting here hanging out.
Let's meet the visiting team, the Chicago Bulls. At small forward, Evan Turner.
I kind of want to go to Chicago.
At center, Joakim Noah. At point guard,
Derrick Rose. DR stands for dear.
At the other guard position,
but in the beginning, Jimmy. I hope the message get near to your conscience. Insight info. Ignore
the head coach of the visiting team is Fred Hoiberg.
The toxic cases is only for the people that don't live through the positive.
Let's meet the Brooklyn Nets.
So I guess at that moment, it's positive.
At the shooting guard position, standing 6'5", number 6, Paul Reed. Starting at the other guard, at 6'3", number 2, Jaren Jack. At power forward, 7 feet, number 77, Andrea Bargnani.
Oh,
the other forward, 6'7", number 7, Joe Johnson.
I'm creating my own.
A 7 foot center from Stanford, number 11, Brooke Lopez.
Am I supposed to be Malone?
Your head coach is Randy Whitman.
Shoot, I will.
Ladies and gentlemen,
we're wearing our costumes. We hope you are too.
Why would I lie?
2K Sports presents the NBA. This is Kevin Harlan along with Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony with Doris Burke reporting on the sidelines. And going against Chicago, their first meeting of the season. They could only manage a single win in four tries against these guys last year.
And this is the first of three games these two teams will play against one another this season.
Yeah, you know, these are two rival teams that will see each other a fair amount this season.
I didn't feel like I did.
If
I did, I would stop like I did now.
We've got a chance here to set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for this one. So the Bulls 5 right now. At the 4, it's Gasol with Noah at the 5. Rose is the 1 with Butler as the 2. And it's Turner in the small forward. Now here's Noah.
That's 2 minutes.
Outside Rose. Down to 5 on the shot clock. 11 feet. feet away, and it's sent by Lopez.
You clock in as soon as you step foot on that.
Now here is Jeff. 11 points for him in that last game against Memphis.
And also, he competed on the backboards. That also had a lot to do with the game.
Here's Bargnani. It's stolen by Rhodes. Butler attacking. The shot will not go. Jack with the defensive effort. Bulls on D. They are coming into this having notched a win against the Knicks in their last game.
And guys, they could have won that game on the strength of their offense alone. It was that good.
And most impressive when you do it on the road like that. They just kept coming at him wave after wave. And they really kept the crowd on mute in that.
And he's got his first chance at the line here.
One shot. One shot.
And Jared Jett, no good on that one. Bulls have gone 0-3 from the field to start the game. Earlier, Doris Burke spoke with head coach Fred Hoiberg. Find out, DB.
I asked him about the matchup problems created by a player like Andrea Bargnani, a 7-foot sharpshooter. He said he can give us problems, no
this
doubt.
Is how I know
it's
most
tough
old
to really
shit.
Bother
now
that
I
shot,
old school
and he can also
16.
Put it on the deck and drive. Okay, we've got to just get into his body
play
and try to make him a facilitator rather than a scorer. Kevin, we'll see if they're successful.
2016 was almost
thank
9
you,
years ago. I mean, 8 years ago.
That free throw good from Butler. So Butler nails both of them. The Nets are gone. 2-3 here to start out the game. And Jack, here we go. His shot is good, making a perfect 2-for-2 from the floor. And so here in Chicago, 4-point game. There's the pick. Rose dishes to Gasol. Nice work there coming off the screen. Gasol. For Chicago, they've gone 5 of 9 from the field here in the first. And Turner kicks to Rose. Second shot opportunity. That one goes. Count.
Guys, he's actually indefatigable. He never gives in, never gives up on a play, and that's what it takes to be a great offensive rebounder. You've got to be relentless.
Pass to Johnson. Lots of room. The rebound by Gibson.
He's got to be disappointed with himself on that one. He has got to knock those down.
Last game for Brooklyn, it was a loss to the Grizzlies in Memphis.
And really, given how they performed offensively, guys, they just never had a chance.
Yeah, and you can see their frustration growing and growing as they continued to come up empty on their possessions. By the end, they were just happy to watch the clock wind down and move on.
Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time getting the lid off the basket so far.
Lopez kicks the free. And Turner with the block. Feeds it to Butler from the arc. Offensive rebound, Noah. Good team by Johnson.
He's going to play his way right onto the bench and out of the game if he continues to shoot it like he has so far in this quarter.
Jack passes to Young. Can't cash in from close range.
That's terrific defense right there to prevent from converting in close.
Rose against Jack, and so it's going to be a 3-second violation out there on the defense.
Hold
For Chicago, they have been perfect at the line so far, albeit just 2-for-2.
And their numbers from the line last season, they're good, just not great, about 77% as a team.
You know, something you can point to when you're talking about their areas of success last season.
Please be reading. Shit, for to get a little quiet so I can make sure y'all really doing what y'all supposed to.
No, that just told you can't. Come on, stop being. Plants outside. Damn, I need to bring them inside the house. Them plants been giving me hope and life. The spider plant and the goddamn, I forgot what the other one called. Spider plant and some other plant. Snake plant, some shit, spider plant and snake plant. I don't like snakes or spiders, but I'm starting to learn to respect. Okay, they have a purpose on this planet. Anything else that's been created on this planet that wasn't meant to be, damn, but that, them bitches can fall with this face of the earth. Bitch, you ain't natural. Anything mankind creates, everything natural. You ain't fucking kid. Let's get it.
Free throw shooting. Here's what Brooklyn's going with right now. Samuel Dalembert, who's checked in for Lopez. Thomas Robinson comes in for Johnson. Hollis Jefferson subbed in for Jarrett Jack. Now here's Brooks. Here's Dunleavy. That drops and it comes off an assist from Brooks.
Another nice bucket down low. They've really been able to work the ball into the post effectively so far.
Yeah, and I think we're going to see them operating a lot of their offense from the interior today.
Dalembert dishes to Freak. Lock at six. Robinson kicks to Young. Here's Campbell. And it's going to be out of bounds. The ball will take it. Let's use this break for a quick look at the squads that really made it happen on the fast break last season. The Bulls in second.
No, I mean, it's a crowd-pleasing style, right? I mean, this club just got out and ran at every possible chance.
Brooks with no one around. There's the basket and make it a double-digit lead. Brooks has got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game. to the paint and stolen by Mirotić. And here we go with Brooks running it up the court. Finished off the break.
Their defense just hasn't been able to slow them down.
And that's a big reason why they're trailing, surrendering too many easy baskets.
All right, now, I want everyone here at the Barclays Center to welcome to the court your next dancer.
Get out of here.
Seven-second difference, shot and game clock. Nets trail by 14. Campbell with it. 11 points for him in that last game against Memphis. They need this.
Ugh.
He lays it in.
And he just big boyed it right there. The height advantage he's got down low, really difficult for them to defend.
Down low, here's Butler.
Oh.
And two free throws coming up as he misses that one, drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. The Bulls have made three free throws so far. Haven't missed any. First free throw is good. Bulls making a switch here. He hits both from the stripe. Here's Campbell. Takes a three. Got it off in time, but it's no
good.
And as we conclude the first quarter, a one-sided game so far. It's the Bulls. They lead by... And Pau Gasol, after some great years and some difficult years, talks about now his newfound excitement. I think you'd have to say that Gasol's decision to go to Chicago, Clark, was great. He clearly gave it a lot of thought, and it's hard to imagine him having made a better pick.
You know, I agree. Not only is he happy, but so are his teammates, Ask Rose and Noah and Butler. Those guys love playing with him, and you can see how the change of scenery rejuvenated the big Spaniard, too.
Yeah. And welcome back. It's been all one-sided so far through the first quarter as our second quarter gets underway. And the Bulls guys have been rolling right along.
Full court press.
A lot of tough D being played by them so far. It's been the difference maker.
Greg, no uncontested shots for the most part. That's why they've had success.
On the court right now, second quarter for the Bulls. At the four, it's Gasol with Noah at the five. Derrick Rose is out there with Brooks. And it's Mirotić in at the three. From the sideline, let's catch up with Doris Burke.
Well, Kev, Freak in the last matchup against the Grizzlies came through when they needed him to. He had 11 points and added a few rebounds as well. Overall, just an incredible bonus for his team as he made a big impact coming off the bench.
All right, Doris, well, what do you guys think? Does that kind of big performance energize a player in his next game?
Guys, it's true, you know, because when you work as hard as he did in that game, you tend to be a little worn down. But on the other hand, he also has to be feeling terrific in terms of the confidence about the state of his game.
Yeah, that's exactly right. I mean, I'd say mentally, he's in peak condition, while physically,
he could probably use a recharge.
Ladies and gentlemen, your Brooklyn Nets.
All right.
Well, we've got a moment to look back at last year's Bulls. Second in blocks, second in opponent points per game. And they had the second most transition points in the league. I mean, you had to strap it on tight when you played these guys because they were coming right at you.
And as you mentioned, so many blocks for them last year. Some highlight reel rejections in that mix over the course of the season. No doubt about it.
Check out these handles. That's rush hour handle. Not midday, not early morning. That's rush hour handle. That nasty spin just froze the defender.
Rose kicks to Brooks. Back to Rose. Noah with a screen for Rose. To the inside. Mirotić passes to Brooks. Nice open look, but it's no good. Nets trail by 14. Outside Jack. Lopez sets a screen for Jack. He dishes it to Freak. From beyond the arc.
Oh.
It's rebounded by Noah. Noah's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Brooks kicks to Rose. Back to Brooks. And good. Got the English that time as it falls. Brooks has got seven.
I mean, even he was surprised to be that open.
Jack against Rose.
Move the ball. Stick it.
Shoots off the step back. Rose with the block. And he's able to get it back.
No
good from Campbell.
Not really sure what he was thinking about on that shot. That is not high IQ basketball.
Not at all. I mean, he shouldn't even have considered taking that shot. Just a poor choice there.
They really want to find that igniter here.
Yeah, that's right. Kevin, the offense has basically been running in place.
They got to get going. Jack dishes to Freak. Not really his range, and it's off target.
And he's really having all sorts of problems with his jumper right now.
Yeah, big time. I mean, the words that come to mind, ice and cold and disappearing stroke, all would apply.
And Jack, here we go. And Brook Lopez, the bucket on the assist from Jack. Lopez has got his first 2 points.
I like it. I like it. He broke out the fancy finish there.
Samuel Gallenberg is checked in for the Nets. Johnson comes in for Bargnani. Then for the Bulls. Mike Dunleavy, he's checked in for Noah. Jimmy Butler comes in for Aaron Brooks. And it's Turner in for Rose. Mirotić, the screen. Dunleavy, the pass to Turner.
Okay.
To the middle. Here's Mirotić. And he comes off the screen and slams it through.
Clearly, they've been the hotter team here in the first half.
Well, they've been grit and grind, working for those high percentage shots. And quite honestly, it's paid off for him.
The pass to Campbell. Fires for three.
Can't
get it to go. Now Chicago takes it the other way.
Plus +8 in the rebound differential. One more reason why they're in control.
Yeah, double-digit advantage on the scoreboard. They've taken the initiative. They've played, I think, with more purpose so far.
Oh, boy, I tell you what, they don't get much uglier than the quarter he's having.
Yeah, and it's not showing any signs, Greg, of turning around here soon. I mean, this touch has basically gone AWOL. Excellent ball.
I don't know why that phone
ain't
go off yet.
And that's
key,
this run, passing it with purpose. The D hasn't been able to keep up.
Lays it in without an inch of room around him. Freak's got his second basket. Here's Chicago. They're on a 14-6 run. And Turner kicks to Dunleavy. The feed to Mirotić. And it's wide right. It's off the rim.
Well, I think he kind of alligator armed that one. Short stroked it. After doing a nice job to get open, he didn't finish the shot.
Campbell kicks to Jack. Screened by Young. Now the dish to Johnson. Just five to shoot. Knocks down the step back J.
Joe Johnson showing us a beautiful stroke right there.
The Bulls leading by 18. Shot and game clock separated by five. And Turner kicks to Mirotić. Good defensive work there by Young. Mirotić dishes to Turner. Back to Mirotić. Misses off the left iron. From deep. And it would have counted had it fallen, but it's offline. So as we conclude the first half, so far fairly one-sided. Bulls lead by 18. And a chance now to...
Listen, I know when to quit and when not to keep going. That don't make me a sorry-ass nigga. It's just sometimes you just gotta be... You gotta know when to... All right, boss, I'm going home, bro. I can't do no more, bro. You trying to work me to the bone, boss. I can't do it no more.
You gotta let boss know you gotta be done with it. You gotta let boss man know, hey, I'm done, boss. So I got 2 days. Third, first, Monday. First, so it's the same day. It's Tuesday. Fourth, fifth, it's here my third. Just, oh shit. To respond. Oh shit, I ain't no idea. Oh, do it by November 13th. doing? Hello?
It's the 2K Sports Pregame Show.
Hello, everybody. Ernie Johnson here alongside Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. Welcome to the NBA on 2K Sports. In this game, we'll see the Atlanta Hawks going up against the Brooklyn Nets. And for Brooklyn, they are hungry for a win here. Last season, they got swept by this team. Four straight losses, something they haven't forgotten. Fellas, it seems like so much goes into being successful at the professional level. I want to ask a more general question. What was the key to your success as a player and as a champion?
You know what? Most people would say you would start at the top, but I'll start where it began. Wilmot Benjamin, Tom Dunning, coaches who helped me at my AAU early stages out, then going to the late, great Jack Curran in high school. Those were the ones. And honestly, there's no bigger than that. My brother Vince, and my dad were the ones who really got me.
Well, you gotta have great teammates, you know. I'm the first one to say, yeah, I have four championships, but one of my favorite teammates, Big Shot Bob, he saved me so many times. Another one of my favorite teammates, B. Shaw, he saved me. Rick Fox, he saved me. So, you gotta have great teammates, great organizations. You know, they allow you to focus on.
He said Kobe?
Strongest family and friends and all that. And Ernie, I remember when you interviewed me when I was 18 years old.
I remember that. I just started at Turner when San Antonio put a feature on Big Shot. Wow, that's incredible. That was. I haven't changed at all, have I?
No, you still look beautiful.
Had more hair.
James,
he's a doctor. He's got good doctors. Let's get to Kevin Harlan. Kev.
Okay.
We're broadcasting from Atlanta as the Hawks take the hardwood here at the Phillips Arena. Last downing for Atlanta. They won that game against the Magic in Orlando. It was just a textbook performance. That game was all there. Once they got it going, it was full speed ahead.
And you know what? Exactly what had to be done in terms of winning on the road. Never allow any momentum to build up against them.
All right. Get the crowd. Y'all got about 5 more minutes.
For every punch they took, they had a count.
For real.
I was very impressed, Greg, with the way they stood their ground, even when they were on their heels some, coming through those moments where they were.
Y'all got 5 more minutes.
That's what it takes on the road. You've got to show that kind of fortitude and resilience.
And so off the tip, it's Brooklyn. All right, let's set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade. All fueled up and ready to go. So for Brooklyn now, they've got Brook Lopez. Johnson is out there with Bargnani. Then it's Lee, and it's Jack in at the point guard position. Johnson, good. Brooklyn on defense, outplayed in the previous game on their schedule, losing to Chicago.
Yeah, their defense got sliced and diced in that game. They just weren't closing down on perimeter shooters.
We ain't going to win every game, bro.
And then they gave up their fair share of those point-blank shots on the interior as well.
Something was clearly amiss for them, Greg. I mean, to let an opponent shoot that high a percentage, you got to take a real long look.
I'm having a fucked up rookie year, though, I ain't going to lie.
Al Horford impeding the defense there with a solid screen. And Jack, here we go. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. Jack's got his first basket of the night.
And when he gets in his head that he's going to get to the basket, very little you can do defensively.
Here's T. And there's the whistle. Fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line.
Yeah, the defender all over.
Greg, he got him good there. I mean, that's why the shot was so far off.
This is his first chance at the line tonight.
And I like what he did at the line a season ago. How about 81%?
And guys, the numbers don't lie. I mean, he was such a reliable presence at the free throw line all throughout last season.
No good on that one.
I'm gonna go out there, bro.
Got it. And it's Campbell in for Lee. The Hawks trail by 4. A moment to check in with Doris Burke. Doris?
Earlier, I was able to catch up with Mike Budenholzer. He said that slowing down Joe Johnson will definitely be a big key for them. He added, Johnson is so big and is able to shoot over the top of you. We just need to make sure that we're always right in his jersey, never losing track of him, and trying to force him into tough, contested shots. Guys, we'll see if they can slow him down.
Thanks, Doris. Now, here is Jeff. Jeff Teague unable to get his shot to go. Johnson outside. Now Campbell knocks it loose. Here's Young. No luck. Good work defensively by Horford.
You can see how much the defense respects him. I mean, they were all over him on that look.
The 11-footer. That's good. And so Teague with the assist. Horford's got his second basket of the night.
And that's really using the double team against the defense there and creating that pinpoint passing to attack.
Johnson the screen. Here's Lopez. No good off the back of the rim.
You're not
going to see that very often. Plenty of space, but he just, let's face it, he whiffs on that.
Teague with the ball. Now Jack defending, and it's Korver off the drive. The score now all even.
Really, really good at recognizing the gaps and getting the ball to the rim.
Screen by Young. Here's Jack. On target from 13.
Nice.
Jack's got seven.
And you can see he's got a little bounce in his step. 3 out of 4 to start.
For Atlanta, they've gone 5 of 9 from the field here in the first. To the inside. Cephalosha's shot is good. Cephalosha's got his first points in this one.
They are really doing a nice job establishing a presence inside early.
And watch, Clark, how the game plays out, because this is going to open things up on the perimeter.
Well, Kevin, we've got a moment now to look back to last year's Atlanta Hawks. Second in assists, third in three-point shooting, and they were third best in the league at scoring off turnovers. A lot of their points were the result of mistakes at the other end.
And from those assist numbers, you can see this was a very unselfish team. Their passing was really infectious and made them a tough team to defend.
And the Hawks have a completely new group on the floor. And then for Brooklyn, Allenberg comes in for Brook Lopez. Robinson is subbed in for Johnson. Hardaway again.
Laps.
Now here is Jack. Guarded by Schroeder.
No one to blame on that one but himself. You get looks like that, you've got to take advantage.
Top Schroeder. Pass to Hardaway. And Dallenberg pulls it down.
Excellent. Really solid job, actually, by the defense to get in his way as he was going up for that one.
Jack against Hardaway. And a wide open look for Freak. Good, and Jack gets the assist. Freak's got himself on the board with 3 there. Atlanta with the ball. Trailing by 5. Schroeder passes to Schroeder. It's stolen by Dallenberg. Here's Campbell. He got it. Oh, we've seen some great shots in the first quarter.